friendly neighborhood cult infiltrator. And, it's King Tommy here, your friendly neighborhood cult infiltrator. It's the time of the cult. They started playing their music and whatnot. So, I'm just about to sit down for some dinner. So I'm just going to let this play. Maybe I'll be back really soon, but we'll take a look at what, the cult is up to. And, they're going to tell lies for sure. So we'll put up the cult tells lies right there. Let's see here. Yeah. Very immersive here today. See how immersive we can make things. Romana Digilo, the communist deep state cult leader, will be here in just a moment to present, and probably a little Darlene Andy, maybe they'll, who knows, maybe we'll see Ricky Manns today, but I'll be back, I'll be back. Good evening.
Greetings and welcome. Welcome all IMs in the Kingdom of Canada and around the world. It is my apologies that we are late. We had technical difficulties and you can only be in the moment. So my apologies to we the people of the Kingdom of Canada and we the people of the world. So it is Tuesday, April 16, 2024. My name is Darlene Andy. And it is my honor and privilege to host this edition of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News. It is Tuesday, April 16, 2024. I'm also your current acting chief of staff and press secretary as appointed by Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, Commander-in-Chief, Head of State, Head of Government, National Indigenous Chief, President, Queen of the Kingdom of Canada, and Queen of the World. I want to welcome all IAMs, whether you're here for the very first time or you've been here since the beginning. Because if you are here to hear the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, you're absolutely at the right place and most definitely in the right timeline. And it is our intention here on these editions of Queen Romana Tell World Vision News to educate, which is why we speak to the power of words, because words have force, they have power, and they have energy. And as important as the words that we speak are, it is the energy, it is the force, the intention behind the words we speak. It matters how you say it. And today's word of the day is free. F-R-E-E. Free in Latin is liber. L-I-B-E-R. Free. So now that we know the root, the truth behind the word free, be mindful when in conversation with other IAMs. And where do we find the truth? As Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo says often, you find the truth within. We are divine manifestors. What we say comes into being, what we speak comes into being. We are connected with God, Grandmaster, Creator. What we speak comes into being. What we think comes into being. We are free. Keep that in mind. So know that when we think and speak, those things come to manifest. That is where the truth is. It's within. Take the time to be with highest self in silence. Go for a walk in Mother Nature. Be with God, Grandmaster, Creator in Mother Nature. And speaking of truth, we also share here on these editions of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News, other platforms domestically and internationally that we also believe to be telling the truth. But please do not take our word for it. Do your own research and be discerning. Because where's the truth? The truth is within. If you take time to be in silence with highest self. We're going to go right to QRTRV. So Queen Romana Tell Real Vision International News Highlights. Migrants are now flooding New York City Hall to protest being moved to shelters instead of luxury hotels. We're going to be referring to a very interesting picture of Russia and the United States, and we'll be showing that to you in just a few moments. You're going to be seeing a video today called the Nuclear Scare Scam, the real cover-up. And finally, you'll be seeing a video by Dr. Stephen Greer. How do you tell the difference between a man-made and extraterrestrial UFO? So that takes us right now to international news. And I want to ask our international presenter from the United States, from the state of Florida, Gina Lee. Gina Lee, are you here to present to We the People?
Greetings, Your Excellency. Can you hear me?
Oh, I think you're on mute, Gina Lee.
Can you hear me now? It should work on my, it's working, I think it's working on my end.
Okay, I can't hear you, but Ken, is anybody hearing Gina Lee at the moment? Because I'm not hearing Gina Lee.
Ken, I'm sorry, I'll keep talking. Oh, I hear
Okay, go ahead, Gina Lee. I cannot hear you, but we will go ahead. I will do my lip reading again. Thank you.
Okay. This is Gina Lee from the state of Florida, presenting for Queen Ramana Tell Real Vision News on behalf of We the People. Before I begin, a reminder to We the People. Anytime we speak in these articles to government, nonprofit, NGO, or titles, these are now the defunct corporations masquerading as We the People government or organization. They have zero authority, zero power, and zero money. They are bankrupt. Excuse me if any names are mispronounced. From X, migrants are now flooding New York City City Hall to protest being moved to shelters instead of the luxury hotels.
So Chris, can you please bring up that picture? That was from it, but not that one, but okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Takeaway. This is the reality of ideological immigration policies. It is not based on common sense. In the end, nationals of that particular country and the illegal migrants suffer while the bureaucrats and politicians enjoy their perks. And now a picture of Russia and the US. This probably needs to be shared to remind all of us. For those who think Russia is all the way on the other side of the world, it's approximately 55 miles from us at the Bering Strait's narrow point. However, in the body of water between Alaska and Russia, known as the Bering Strait, there lies two small islands known as Big Diomede and Little Diomede. Interesting enough, Big Diomede is owned by Russia, while Little Diomede is owned by the US. The stretch of water between these two islands is only about 2.5 miles wide and actually freezes over during the winter, so you could technically walk from the US to Russia on this seasonal sea ice. Takeaway: the We the People of the world, without exception, Russia and America have always been friends and allies. It's only the select few, the politicians and bureaucrats, who create the false narrative to create division and resentment between the two countries' people for their own agenda. Now we go on to video of Ghislaine Windsor of Richland, Washington. The nuclear scare scam, the real cover-up. QRTRV News is only showing the introductory segment of this video, which gives We the People an idea of this IAMS credentials and experience.
I'm pleased to have as our guest Mr. Ghislaine Windsor from Richland, Washington. I first heard of Ghislaine from a tape that somebody gave to me some months ago, and I found his story to be absolutely fascinating. His story is unique, to say the least. Ghislaine has been in 77 different cities in the last 2 years lecturing on the subject of nuclear energy. The majority of his life, the last 35 years, he spent processing plutonium from nuclear reactor sites. He has worked in the Manhattan Project facilities in Hanford, Washington, Oak Ridge National Laboratories and Nuclear Plant in Oak Ridge, Tennessee, General Electric's Midwest Fuel Recovery Plant in Morris, Illinois, General Electric's Fuel Fabrication Facility in San Jose, California, and Wilmington, North Carolina. And he's worked in every major reactor decommissioning project around this nation up to this present time. His major work in these projects has been the analytical process inventory control, which means that he was responsible for measuring and controlling the nuclear fuel inventory for these projects. Galen Windsor has few peers in the world in this area of expertise. And those few peers admittedly know and agree with the things that you'll be hearing on this tape. However, except for two or three of these experts, they've all chosen to remain silent for reasons which they only know, leaving this man, then, the burden of leading this lonely battle of exposing what we call the nuclear scare scam. He's without question one of the world's foremost authorities in nuclear radiation measurement, and he's recognized by members of the Atomic Energy Commissions of all the major nations of the free world. Mr. Galen Windsor.
Thank you, Ben. We've been considering today how best to approach this subject so that you would feel comfortable with where I am. And we thought it might be appropriate to start with how I got involved in this game. Now, in 1945, I was a Navy radioman out in the Pacific on a destroyer aimed for Japan. We had a one-way ticket. That's all you get, just one way. So, as we were becoming proficient at our business of fighting war, the Manhattan Project caught up with us and did a job. Now, the weapon that was dropped on Hiroshima, Japan in August 6, 1945 was a U-235, fully enriched U-235 weapon, where the material was separated and purified in Oak Ridge, Tennessee. The one that was dropped August 9th on Nagasaki was a plutonium weapon made at Hanford. But to those of us out in the Pacific, it was quite interesting. It had a ticket on it that says, you get to go home. I was impressed.
You can cut the video there, now, Chris. Thank you.
Takeaway. It's a scam that made the military-industrial complex very profitable. Now, video by Dr. Stephen Greer. How do you tell the difference between a man-made and extraterrestrial UFO?
Floating. How are you able to tell which one of these are man-made versus ET?
If you're up close enough, the man-made ones are going to have components, protrusions, electromagnetic. There are going to be seams, welding marks. Underneath, there could be pipes and other things. It's very clearly a man-made machine. The extraterrestrial ones, seamless. They're extruded in this process of how they create them. Even the light they give off is very different because it's coming through such pure material science. Extremely pure materials, technologies and material science that are far beyond. Look at what Stephen Digna talked about, that Raytheon device. Out of a million people who would have seen or touched that thing, 1 million of them would have said it was extraterrestrial. No one would have thought we had that kind of technology. AI, organic quality to it. You look at his testimony carefully.
This is Gina Lee from the state of Florida presenting for Queen Ramona Tell Real Vision News on behalf of We the People. Have a grand evening. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Gina Lee, who's presenting from the state of Florida, and our presenter from the United States. Thank you so much. And a lot of video footage today and great articles. And in relation to the video of Ghislain Windsor of Richland, Washington, the nuclear scam, I highly encourage we the people to watch that video in its totality. It's over an hour, so obviously we could only show you a little clip. But definitely all the videos and articles shared here on Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News, we encourage we the people to watch and read in their totality. So thank you so much, Gina Lee, for that presentation today. And I'm going to segue now into the contribution segment of today's Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News. And you'll see on the banner below that there are several ways to make those contributions. And I want to thank personally, we the people of the Kingdom of Canada for their contributions. I want to thank our international contributors. And of course, I want to thank the Royal Family for their contributions. The work of Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didolo is truly 24/7. I had a conversation today about 24/7 work, and obviously you have to rest somewhere in the day. However, I have been traveling with Her Royal Majesty, as have many of the team, for years now, and Her Royal Majesty really and truly does work 24/7. The amount of work that Her Royal Majesty does for we the people and does not get paid. Actually, we are indebted to Her Royal Majesty many, many thousands of dollars. It's in
so much money that you owe this person who is, by your own description, always awake, constantly working 24/7. That sounds like complete insanity, not borderline. That sounds like pushing yourself way over the edge. Imagine not sleeping and consistently working for 3 years straight without 24/7. I mean, I think you would die after the first couple of days. But Darlene makes some pretty outstanding claims, doesn't she?
The new law of the Kingdom of Canada, and you can see the royal decree's work rippling all over the world. So with that, for those that choose to continue the contributions for the continued journey and work of Her Royal Majesty and team, there are several ways that those contributions can be made. So for those that choose the e-transfer email method, there are two email addresses, and those are...
Actually, the best email address to use if you want to support something that is valuable in media in Canada, maybe you should support your local independent media. It's Community TV, the Trash Panda. That's me. I'm Trash Panda Tommy. I'm Tall Bike Tommy. I'm Tommy, the Community TV guy. Hey, it's me. You can send me money at support@comtv.ca. If you like independent journalism, it's probably something that you would benefit from. If you really think about it, the independent journalists are here to protect the communities. I mean, we are the fifth estate. If the government's going to lie to you, we're going to find out and tell you, so you can get mad as hell. Right? Maybe grab a pitchfork or something, you know? Or a torch. But, you know, you can get mad as hell and then not take it anymore, and that's the first step. But without that first step, nothing happens. And I'm the guy who gets you mad as hell, right? Well... who's taking it? Who's mad? Who wants things to change? Let me know what you're thinking about. Darlene might be done grifting at this point. Let's check in with Darlene.
D-I-N-S. So, for those that have not been... it's auto-correcting, so for those that didn't spell out Kevin and Desjardins...
Nobody knows how to spell anything. Seems like it's a difficult thing to manage over there, to not get scammed when you're scamming. It's like they're on Telegram, so they can do their scam. But there's other scammers on Telegram, So the scammers scam their scam, and then the people who are getting scammed are still getting scammed. They're just getting scammed by other scammers. It's an amazing world of scam cycle happening over there on the Telegram app. We're watching on Rumble right now, actually. A lot of grifting goes on Rumble as well. A lot of crazy people have access to the internet, folks. I mean, that's just how she goes.
An e-transfer. But remember, there's two emails only at this moment.
Okay, there's only at this moment two emails because, you know, a well-organized, well-engineered government machine like the Kingdom of Canada, of course, needs to accept e-transfers through Gmail accounts from random people that seem to hop on an RV. That's really the best way to organize your finances, of course, when you're a whole entire nation or something.
Soon to be live streaming on YouTube.
Oh, they're going to be TikTok on YouTube soon, guys.
And Truth
Look
Social.
Out.
So again, I want to go through the actual addresses of each of the platforms, because again, there are those that become creative, and it's very important that we write these things down. So if you have close to a pen and paper, I highly encourage you to write these down so that you can put them in as they are meant to be put in, to have the real...
So geriatric that you keep a pen and paper next to your laptop? Well, get ready to write down some HTTP.
Rumble. QRTRV, all caps, capital N, and then the word news. On X, it's at HRMQR, all caps. Truth Social, at HRMQR, all caps. TikTok, this is the only change, at HRMQRD. So on TikTok, the only one that you add a D to, at HRMQRD. And then, of course, the website, thekingdomofcanada.ca. Thekingdomofcanada.ca. And to we the people, as a reminder, as the weather gets warmer, we are preparing to paint the school in purple and gold. And pardon me, it's the private property of His Excellency Ricky Lee Mance. It was a previous school. And to turn part of the
invite me to paint
property
the school
into a garden. You'll be seeing that happen very soon. And this very important announcement, and the Kingdom of Canada nationals who have been issued their Canadian nationality card. The Kingdom of Canada nationality card will be issued their Kingdom of Canada passport very soon. So very exciting news for we the people of the Kingdom of Canada. And that takes us now to domestic news. April 16, 2024. In the Kingdom of Canada, Province of British Columbia. I am Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, Commander-in-Chief, President, National Indigenous Chief, and Queen of the Kingdom of Canada, hereby officially appoint and congratulate in the province of British Columbia the following provincial ministers. Number one, Minister of Housing, His Excellency Michael Hawkins. Number two, Minister of Finance, Her Excellency Cindy DeRocher. Number three, Minister of Family, Her Excellency Melanie Hope Rinker. And number four, Minister of Well, Her Excellency Teresa Marie Beck. And so it is. Peace and prosperity and love. Politics zero, religion zero. And this very important announcement of these official appointments by Her Royal Majesty on Tuesday, April 16th, from Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, Commander-in-Chief, Head of Government, Head of State, President, National Indigenous Chief, and Queen of the Kingdom of Canada. Where we go one, we go all. April 16, 2024. In the Kingdom of Canada. Greetings, ever E1. Are you now seeing the ongoing takedown of the old system guards using the legacy media, MSM? And so it is. Peace and prosperity and love. Politics zero, religion zero. And this very important post dated today from Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, Commander-in-Chief, Head of Government, Head of State, President, National Indigenous Chief, and Queen of the Kingdom of Canada. Where we go one, we go all. April 16, 2024. In the Kingdom of Canada. Hold on to your seats. QRTRV News has a special guest who worked on multiple Indigenous reserves, and in bracket, more than five reserves, close bracket, as a social worker, and will be sharing her professional experiences working on the reserves. And so it is. Peace and prosperity and love.
We have an expert on families from Politics Child zero, and Family Services.
Religion zero.
Boys and kids.
And this very important post today, April 16, 2024, from Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, Commander-in-Chief, Head of Government, Head of State, President, National Indigenous Chief, and Queen of the Kingdom of Canada. Where we go one, we go all. And that takes us now to our local Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News segment. And we're going to the territory of Northwest Territories. Do we have Her Excellency Cindy Desrochers here to present to We the People?
Grand evening, Your Excellency. Nice to see you.
Grand evening and congratulations.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. I'm so honored and blessed. And thank you to our Queen. This evening, Her Excellency Cindy Desrochers presenting for QRTRV News on behalf of We the People of the Kingdom of Canada.
I always appreciate being able to hang out at Cindy's place for a little while because
these articles in government titles, nonprofit NGOs that they are now the fake, defunct corporations masquerading as We the People's government organization, as they have zero authority, zero power, and zero money. They are bankrupt. Northwest Territories, the territory of Northwest Territories, MSN.com. Report finds unhoused Indigenous women in Yellowknife are, quote, over-policed and under-protected by the RCMP, close quote. A new research report from the Yellowknife Women's Society, YKWS, has found that unhoused Indigenous women in the Northwest Territories capital are, quote, over-policed and under-protected by the RCMP, close quote. Quote, what we heard is that there is a lot of urgency for all levels of government to take action on improving the relationship between the RCMP and unhoused Indigenous women, close quote, said report. Quote, what we heard is that unhoused Indigenous women do not trust the RCMP. They're afraid of the RCMP, and they're often harmed by the RCMP, and they do not feel protected by the RCMP, close quote. The information in the 100-page report was collected in, quote, sharing circles, close quote, involving unhoused Indigenous women living in the city who described being, quote, abused, dismissed, and belittled by RCMP officers, close quote. While YKWS's report asserted that there's a major rift between police officers and unhoused Indigenous women in Yellowknife, it also identified, quote, gaps in much needed services like mental health and housing in the Northwest Territories that directly contribute to a higher frequency of interactions between the RCMP and unhoused Indigenous women, close quote. The report laid out 24 recommendations intended to make Yellowknife a safer city for unhoused Indigenous women, hopeful that the recommendations will be taken seriously by the RCMP and policymakers at all levels of government. Quote, we made 24 recommendations because this is a very complex issue, close quote, she said. Quote, simple steps like increasing housing, shelter services, and funding for programs like YKWS's street outreach van would go a long way towards reducing the frequency of interaction between unhoused women and the RCMP, and it would also reduce harm. Now, according to the report, 90% of the unhoused population in Yellowknife is Indigenous, which stands in stark contrast to the fact that roughly a quarter of the city's overall population is Indigenous. Quote, I've been roughed up by three cops, quote, at once, close quote, said one woman. Quote, I'm not that big, you know, question mark. That's ridiculous, close quote. Now another woman added, quote, seeing how rough the police are with people downtown, it's just unnecessary for them to do that, bracket, to be, close bracket, that harsh, close quote. Quote, you get into a fight with somebody that abuses you downtown, it doesn't matter because you're an alcoholic, bracket, because you're, close bracket, Indigenous, because we're homeless, close quote, a third woman said. Quote, we're street people, we're garbage, and that's how they think, close quote. Quote, I don't get the impression that people are unaware, close quote, she said. Quote, I think that one of the best things about the North is how much emphasis we place on community, close quote. Quote, I'm very optimistic that the community of Yellowknife, both Indigenous and non-Indigenous, wants to take care of members of our community who are unhoused, many of whom are residential school survivors, bracket 60s scoop survivors, the children of those survivors, and people who are currently living out the legacy of colonialism in the North, close quote. Takeaway. They are over-policed and under-protected. They are over-policed and under-protected. Sound familiar? Question mark, question mark, question mark. Now, I am Her Excellency Cindy Desrochers, presenting for Queen Romana Tel Rio Vision News from the province of British Columbia for the Northwest Territories on behalf of we the people of the Kingdom of Canada. Have a wonderful evening and good night to you all. Thank you.
Good night. Good night, Cindy. Your Excellency, Cindy DeRoche, a very powerful article from Her Excellency, Cindy DeRoche, and again, a huge congratulations to Her Excellency, Cindy DeRoche, upon her appointment. That takes us now to the province of Quebec. Do we have Her Excellency Kim Elizabeth Price here to present to We the People?
Good evening, Your Excellency, Darlene.
Good evening.
Nice to see you. Hi, I am. I'm Kim Elizabeth Price, presenting for Queen Ramona Tell Real Vision News on behalf of We the People of the Kingdom of Canada. And I'm very honored tonight to present an article from Quebec, the Globe and Mail, and a reminder again that anytime the words government or titles or NGOs are mentioned in our articles, these are the now defunct corporations masquerading in costumes as We the People's government. They have no authority, no power, no money. They are bankrupt. Again, Globe and Mail. Foreign landlord fails to pay taxes. CRA goes after tenant. A Montreal tenant was audited and ordered to pay the tax he had failed to withhold on the monthly rent to his non-resident landlord as required by law. As a result, he was ordered to pay 6 years worth of tax, as well as the compounded interest and penalties. The Canada Revenue Agency, bracket CRA, could not collect against his overseas landlord. So the Canadian tenant was on the hook. Last year, the tenant took the Minister of National Revenue to court, arguing that he did not know his landlord was a non-resident. The tenant, whose Italy-based landlord owned a single unit in a Montreal building, lost the tax court appeal on the grounds that they were a Canadian resident paying rent to a non-resident landlord and were therefore required to withhold and remit 25% of the rent to the CRA. The judge acknowledged, quote, the harsh consequences, end quote, in her decision, but still held the, quote, resident payer, end quote, or renter liable. The problem with the law is that rent is treated the same as a royalties or similar payments. In other words, residential tenants are held to the same standard as, quote, a sophisticated business, he said. Not knowing a landlord is a non-resident is not considered a valid excuse. Quote, it's concerning, said Mr. Liu, but it's very hard to go after the non-resident, so they put the burden on the tenant. You have to ask yourself, who has the leverage? Obviously, the tenant does not have the leverage. It's well known that non-resident owners have long had to pay withholding taxes on properties they either sell or rent out. However, few renters and few in the real estate business are aware that if those taxes don't get paid, the tenant could be on the hook, said a longtime realtor. All renters and all small mom and pop landlords should be formally educated on the risks to tenants. Non-resident landlord who owns 3 rental units in Vancouver and lives in Hong Kong said he didn't know about the withholding tax, but his property manager has it covered. Licensed property managers are responsible for collecting the taxes, which takes the burden off the tenant, assuming they pay through a property manager. Quote, it sounds unfair for the tenants to be expected to handle this accounting rule. Can you imagine all the stress they are facing with having to hustle to pay their rents and the rising cost of living? And then to discover that there's a whole complicated payments rule they are expected to manage, end quote. To protect themselves, tenants could start asking for statutory declarations from their landlords, attesting to their tax residency status. But the landlord could move out of the country and their status changes and the tenant doesn't know. Quote, in the context of a housing crisis, making them also investigate the residency status of their landlords, end quote. I'm not saying that that's not the law, and the tenant has to be careful of that. The question is this the right thing for the now defunct CRA as a matter of policy to be doing, end quote. Takeaway. The old system failed to do their work. They failed to enforce their own policies on the foreigners, so they take it out on the nationals. How corrupt can they be? It was their responsibility, and they passed the buck on to someone else. I am Kim Elizabeth Price, presenting for QRTRV News for the province of New Brunswick and the province of Quebec on behalf of we, the people of the Kingdom of Canada. Blessings to all. Good night. And so it is.
And so it is. Thank you, Your Excellency Kim Elizabeth Price. A very powerful and interesting article. Thank you for sharing that. And that takes us now to the province of Ontario. Do we have Brenda Price here to present to We the People?
Good evening, Your Excellency.
Good evening.
This is Brenda Price presenting for Queen Ramana Telreal Vision News on behalf of the We the People of the Kingdom of Canada. A reminder to We the People, all reporting in regards to the Corporation of Canada and all its affiliates I speak of are now the defunct corporation masquerading as We the People's government is now null and void. They have no power, no authority, zero money, and they are bankrupt. Thunder Bay Police Chief vows to rebuild eroding trust after ex-chief arrested. Criminal charges against the former Thunder Bay Police Chief and other high-ranking members have sown further doubt in the credibility of the embattled force in Northern Ontario. Its current leaders acknowledged Monday as they vowed to rebuild confidence in the service. Chief Darcy Fleury and Police Board Chair Karen Machado held a joint press conference to address last week's arrest of ex-chief Sylvia Houth and the service's former in-house lawyer in an ongoing misconduct investigation. Quote, the criminal allegations brought forward by the Ontario Provincial Police are deeply disturbing, close quote, Machado said. Quote, I understand how these allegations have caused further doubts in these institutions and the system of policing and police oversight in Thunder Bay, close quote. Quote, despite numerous reports, nothing has happened to enhance the public's trust in the TBPS. In fact, the Thunder Bay public, and especially Indigenous people, now have even more reason not to trust the police, close quote, in a statement that represents 49 First Nations. Scathing oversight reports dating back to 2018 have documented systematic racism in the Thunder Bay Police Force and outlined how investigations into the sudden deaths of Indigenous people had been tainted by racist attitudes and stereotyping. Several of those investigations were so poorly handled, they had to be reinvestigated. Other reports have noted how allegations of misconduct that previously embroiled the board and police service under Howth delayed action on the oversight report's recommendations. Ex-Chief Sylvie Howth and former in-house lawyer Holly Welburn both faced charges of obstruction of justice and breach of trust for allegedly making false statements to the police board and the Ontario Civilian Police Commission. As part of the same misconduct investigation, OPP in December charged Officer Michael DeMinney with two counts of assault and one count each of breach of trust and obstruction of justice for alleged offense taking place in 2014, 2016, and 2020. Takeaway. As Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didolo has said before, when your police chief is clean, your city is clean. Crimes will not thrive when the police chief is telling his officers to clean up the city and to not allow any type of crime or corruption! Exclamation mark. This is Brenda Price presenting for Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News on behalf of the We the People of the Kingdom of Canada. Back to you, Her Excellency.
Thank you so much, Brenda Price. Again, another powerful article from the province of Ontario. And that takes us now to the province of Manitoba. And is Her Excellency Melanie Hope Rinker here to present to We the People?
Greetings, Your Excellency, Darlene.
Greetings and congratulations, Your Excellency, on your appointment by Her Royal Majesty. Congratulations.
Thank you. This is Melanie Hope Rinker presenting for Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News on behalf of We the People of the Kingdom of Canada. Anytime we speak in these articles to government, nonprofit, NGOs, or titles, these are the now defunct corporations masquerading as We the People's government or organizations. They have zero power, zero authority, and zero money. They are bankrupt. Global news. Manitoba First Nation chief charged with child-related sex crime. Lake St. Martin First Nation, man's chief has been charged with sexual assault, sexual interference, and making and possessing child pornography. Winnipeg police said Christopher Travers was arrested and charged on February 1, and the victim was an elementary school-aged child. It said more information is not available due to the nature of the investigation. The provincial courts said the offenses happened on December 29, 2023. Travers referenced a petition calling him to resign, saying, quote, "That shouldn't have started because they don't know the other side of the story," closed quote. He said he would not be stepping down. The Assembly of Manitoba Chiefs, in parentheses, AMC, published a release acknowledging Travers was arrested and charged with criminal offenses. Quote, "The AMC is not aware of the particulars of these charges and does not comment on any ongoing legal matters involving chiefs. close quote. It said, adding, it will ensure appropriate support is available for those impacted. Takeaway, how rampant is this on reservations in the Kingdom of Canada? How long has this been going on? I am Melanie Hope Rinker, presenting for Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News on behalf of we, the people of the Kingdom of Canada. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Your Excellency Melanie Hope Rinker, for that very powerful article, and perhaps we'll be hearing more about that takeaway. And for our last article of today's Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News Local, from the province of British Columbia, do we have His Excellency Michael Hawkins here to present to we the people.
Greetings, everyone.
Greetings. Before you start out, Your Excellency Michael, I did want to congratulate you. I see that you're in a new location, but I did want to congratulate you on your appointment.
Thank you so much.
Provincial Minister of Housing in the province of British Columbia.
Minister of Housing.
Wonderful.
Thank you so much. Is he getting kicked out of his house and live in a motel now?
This is Michael Hawkins presenting for Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News on behalf of we the people of the Kingdom of Canada. Before I begin, a reminder to we the people that anytime we share these articles of government titles, nonprofit, and NGOs, these are the now defunct corporations masquerading as we the people's government or organizations. They have zero authority, zero power, zero money. They are bankrupt. From the province of British Columbia, from Czech News, BC construction sector seeks support as workers' shortage, late payments persist. British Columbia's construction industry says its workforce numbers have improved in recent years, but labor shortages persist and are putting, quote, extreme pressures, end quote, on employers. The BC Construction Association says the shortage of qualified workers has pushed the average annual wage in the sector to just short of $75,000, up 21% in the last 5 years. The association says the average entry-level wage for construction workers is now at more than $22 an hour, 25% above minimum wage in the province. In a statement, it was said that labor levels have improved and a projected deficit of 6,600 skilled workers in BC by 2033 compared to a forecasted need of 26,100 by 2023, estimated a decade ago. The industry still saw the number of trade workers drop by 7% over the last 5 years to 167,300. And the average construction company in the province has seen its size contract by 15% during this time. The association says construction companies also face persistent uncertainty when it comes to getting paid for their work, with contractors possibly having to, quote, wait months for payment, end quote. Also, quote, they experience significant financial risk and take on increased cost of debt, which can put them in danger of bankruptcy, the association statement says. They are put in the position of financing construction projects, including the housing BC desperately needs, end quote. Relief to the industry is being requested, which is responsible for 229,100 employees and $27 billion, or 10.3% of the province's GDP. And the takeaway, who are project owners who are not paying the general contractors and subcontractors? I'll repeat, who are project owners who are not paying the general contractors and subcontractors? This is His Excellency Michael Hawkins reporting on behalf of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News from the province of British Columbia on behalf of the We the People of the Kingdom of Canada. Grand evening, one and all.
Grand evening. Thank you so much, Your Excellency Michael Hawkins. And again, I want to repeat, because this is questions that We the People need to ask and research and document your responses. So in the province of British Columbia, who are the project owners who are not paying the general contractors and subcontractors? Please do your research and post your results on the main channel. Please and thank you. Please do some investigative reporting. That's why we have you here with us. Thank you.
That's why you're watching.
And before we bring us to the close of this edition with the quote of the day gifted to us by Her Royal Majesty Queen Romana Didelo, the reminder that we have Her Excellency Deep Calming Soul here from the province of Manitoba to share the French edition of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News, Tuesday, April 16, 2024. And to the quote of the day, many people are fearful of being completely free to lead their own lives because it is a massive responsibility. Have you here with us. Thank you. That's many people and fearful of being completely free to lead their own lives because it is a massive responsibility. That is the truth and a very powerful quote from Her Royal Majesty. Thank you. So with that, everyone, thank you for joining me here today on this edition of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News. My name is Darlene Ondi. I am your current acting host of Queen Romana Tell Real Vision News Monday to the fifth day of the week. I'm your current acting chief of staff and press secretary as appointed by Her Royal Majesty.
I am, of course, King Tommy, self-proclaimed just the same as Romana Didelo. There's no validity to my honorarium there. My honorary titles are completely made up, just like Didelo's. But I am a security analyst expert, especially in the field of temporary construction fences. So if you ever need me to, you know, give you an audit on your temporary construction fence, or if you've got royal puppies, you know who to call. You just call, simply call my corporate overlords at 1-888-600-7029. Global Research Labs will give me feedback about what you tell them. If you just call them at 1-888-600-7029. Yes, once again, it's legally required that three times during the show I tell you that my corporate overlords want you to call them at 1-888-600-7029. That phone number again is 1-888-600-7029. Thank you for watching.